مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. إن شاء الله we We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that this particular dhikr or salawat that we'll be reading, inshallah, sending salutations on Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Yama'u Allah ilayya. That the salutations, it is presented to me. So inshallah, as we are making the salawat as well, inshallah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this salawat will be presented to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if a person sends one salutation on Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah then in turn sends 10 mercies on that person. Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. We have all the brothers here that's going to be making the adhkar. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. So without further ado,
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس صلي أفضل صلوات على لا إله إلا الله. كررها They told Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was a madman.
Like today, we find that we also have to be in the defense of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. People, when they are starting to, you know, go overboard with regards to a Muslim or the life of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or start to draw cartoons of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know that love of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it doesn't behove of us to keep ourselves back, but to speak about it and say, subhanallah, this man, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who has sacrificed his life for us, it is just right of us also to say, you know, this is our Prophet. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save God and protect the Muslims and protect the name of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in one very beautiful hadith, Ahsin ila man a'asa'a ilayk. Be good to those that are bad to you. Be good to those that are bad to you. We know the history of Khalid ibn Walid before he was a Muslim. That Khalid ibn Walid, he actually killed many of the Sahaba's family members. Subhanallah, look at this. But when he came into the fold of Islam, the Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, anyone but Nadim. But what was his name after he embraced Islam? What's called? Saifullah. Khalid ibn Walid, Saifullah. He was the sword of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he made so much inroads into the fold of Islam. People came and many battles were fought by Khalid ibn Walid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, may Allah save God us. So, أحسن إلى من أساء إليك. Those that are bad to you, be good to them. This is a sign of good character. Look at Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the battle of Uhud. Many of the Muslims, they were mutilated by the kuffar. But if you look at Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they asked Nabi sallallahu to make dua against him, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, may Allah have mercy on them, because they don't know what they are doing. Imagine, look at that level. Sometimes we go in a society, we go to some, even family members, for that extent. We go to family members, friends, whoever it is, and we say, this brother, you know, he's maybe a bit rowdy, or he speaks maybe it's not on my level, if I had to say it or put it in that way. In that instance also, I should overlook him. Part of akhlaq is that I overlook people. And I say to myself, first of all, you know, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide this particular individual. That is having good akhlaq. People that bad mouth us, people that speak ill of us, this was the character of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He made to voice enemies. Imagine that level, that standing of akhlaq. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with the birth of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From a young age already, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, truthful, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, that when Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam took out the heart of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and washed it with Ma'am Samsam, as it comes in the narration, he said, Jibreel said, we have never ever seen a heart like this. We have never ever seen a heart like this. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's heart, what a beautiful heart Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had. And if you look at all of that darkness was taken out of the heart of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to that extent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua and said, oh Allah, you have mercy on them, the enemies of Islam, oh Allah, because they don't know what they are doing. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this particular ayah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And indeed, you are of the greatest of moral character. Imagine overlooking people to that extent. Sometimes people wrong me. And it happened to many of us already. People have trampled on us. They slandered us. They have ill-treated us. They have backbited about us. They have made tales about us. But still, we say, maybe he doesn't know why he's doing what he's doing. Imagine, people have spoken bad about people that you like. And still we say, inshallah, maybe they didn't. Maybe they don't know what they are doing. Now for this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah about the Messiah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that you are on the greatest of moral character. The akhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you look at Imam al-Ghazali, he speaks about the akhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he says that akhlaq can be divided into three categories, in our af'al, our aqwal, and in our aqidah. We have to have full belief. We must believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe عَمَدُ اللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ and we will be resurrected after we pass away. But in our aqwal as well, akhlaq is in our aqwal as well. The way we speak, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it comes in one hadith, and Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, قال لم يكن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فاحشا ولا متفحشا كان يقول إن من خياركم أحسنكم أخلاقا متفق عليه. Then in one hadith, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, قال he said that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was never viewed or immoral, and he never pretended to be immoral. You know, sometimes you have to put up an act. When you come to some people now, you have to try and move yourself in the direction. But Nabi Sallam never used to be who he was. They even used to tell Nabi Sallam, just to digress a bit off the point, they told Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you know, what is it that you are preaching? If you want to be the richest person in Medina, we will make you the richest person in Medina. If you want, we can give you the most beautiful woman in Makkah and Medina all together. Just leave what you're preaching. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, if you have to put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left hand, I will never ever leave what I'm preaching. But Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never used to be immoral. He always used to be upright. He always used to overlook people. He used to carry the burden of those people that were weak. He used to carry the burden of the poor. He used to forgo his rights. We know so many qisas of Aisha radiallahu anha, Fatima radiallahu anha, that they used to forgo, with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's advice to them also, used to forgo their rights for others. And for days they never ate, or for days they stay eating only dates. This was the akhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah give it to us. My dear brothers and sisters, it is not just, you know, Mawlid Nabi, celebrating the birth of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, more so should be that we put the character of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our life. This is celebrating Mawlid al-Nabi. Putting that akhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our life. This is what more will make Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam happy. Yes, we should also bring the salawat ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because every salawat, when we make it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us so much tawab. And for this, my dear brothers and sisters, when we carry out the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the akhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith of Allah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن المؤمن ليدرك بحسن الخلق درجة الصائم والقائم. Imagine to have good akhlaq, you will get the daraja, the standing, the status of a person that's fasting and a person that is standing whole night in Qiyamul Layl. How meritorious it is to stand in Qiyamul Layl. But look at this beautiful hadith. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that, you know, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it, you know, that a person that has got good character, good akhlaq, good morals, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him this type of a status. Overlooking people, you know, keeping up the flag of truthfulness, doing what Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. Subhanallah, walking like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talking like him, being like him with your family members, being like you with like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with your neighbors, being like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the Musalleen. What was the akhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was with people? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was rahmatul lil'alameen. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most merciful. The most merciful. I mean, even in his qabr, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I will still worry about you even in my grave. To that extent that to the also our actions are conveyed to our salawat, it's conveyed to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all this beautiful character, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those people that, you know, we can be from amongst those people that, you know, that when we die one day, that we can have that very close relationship with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we can drink from the whole kawthar of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, just to end off, my dear brothers and sisters, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisani wa yadi. Al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisani wa yadi. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that a Muslim is he that others are protected from his hands and his tongue. Today people are saying, reflecting things, they are saying things about Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are saying things about the deen. Okay, now my dear brothers, yes, we have to stand up. Because if you are not going to stand up, You know how propaganda works like that, politics, you know, and the way that people want to destroy Islam, you know, they are going to go and they're going to go to that extent. That don't be surprised that if you see that the mountain is moved from one place to the next, this is how they are plotting and planning. Day and night, the kuffar, they are plotting and planning just to destroy Islam. May Allah safeguard us, may Allah protect us, may Allah keep us steadfast. And you know, for this, my dear brothers and sisters, we must make dua for the Ummah. One of the things that Nabi Sallam loved, the things that Nabi Sallam loved, he loved his Ummah. He loved, and if we too, we love the Ummah, and we pray for the Ummah, we ask Allah daily, oh Allah, grant hidayah to the Ummah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Inshallah, through that also we will become many close to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq and understanding. You know, this being the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, many of our mashayikh, they have also made mention and they said that many people in this particular month, they see Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the dream. How beautiful would that be? Say that if some people, they see Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the dream, it even increases the iman also. They'll change their life also. We know non-Muslims became Muslim by seeing Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the dream. Some people see Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the dream, بِكَثَرَ بِالصَّلَاةِ عَلَى النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. They saw Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the dream by making a lot of salawat, sending abundance of salutations on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And so, whoever of us, we send, you know, salutations on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then inshallah, we too, hopefully, may Allah make it easy for us that we can see Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in our dream. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it such that inshallah that we can be with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in Jannah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us, inshallah, that we can send an abundance of salutations on Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's many forms of sending salutations on Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shortest form, you can just say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq and understanding. You know, there's a very beautiful poem that is with regards to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, I just want to end off with that. You know, Hassan ibn Thabit, we hear this particular poem, we have read it many times in, you know, in our qasaid. We hear people saying this particular poem of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hassan ibn Thabit used to be a poet and used to write poetry. And he wrote a very beautiful, beautiful poem of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says, أَحْسَنَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَى قَطُّ وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب كأن قد خلقت كما تشاء. He says that better than you, the eye have never ever seen. Better than, subhanAllah, look at Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha radiallahu anha said, you know, just to mention of the things that I've heard of the ulama, what they said, that they said that the real beauty of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was not really revealed. That also, to such an extent, some Imam Al-Qurtubi, he says that there were some veils to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because if people had to really see Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they wouldn't be able to look at him because of the brightness of his nur. Inshallah, there's no time to get into that. Some of the mashayikh, their nur is very bright. People you can see on them also, just reading salawat ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases their light. Allah gives him nur. Allah grants him abundance of nur. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Aisha radiallahu anha says that Nabi Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, when they saw in the woman's sitting, saw Nabi Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, they were starting to cut their hands. But she says that if the woman had to see Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would cut their hearts. Imagine the beauty of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Hassan ibn Thabit, he said, وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. He says, they're more beautiful than you, no woman has given birth to. خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّعَ مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ كَأَنَّ قَدَ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. He says that you have been created free from anything, from all defects, as if you were created like how you desired. Imagine, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq. I heard someone was, you know, saying this. This is like a saying, you know, if I could have created myself, exam now, you know, if you could have created yourself, you would still be busy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq. Because, you know, people want to beautify themselves in this way. Most beautiful was Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Most beautiful features was upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Most beautiful akhlaq was Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah says that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on the highest standing of moral character. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us that we can emulate Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.